Okay, so be honest. When you first met me, mine, it was just all about the chase.
Well, I mean, you did despise me. Made it a heck of a challenge.
I did. But then I had to find out that you were interesting and funny.
Yeah, and I had to find out the same thing. I wasn't prepared for what happened next.
Which was what?
The worst possible thing. I fell for you.
The worst possible thing? Well, that's romantic.
I just wasn't part of the plan. Old habits die hard.
You know what? You can't put this all on me. They're going to ask you questions, too.
Oh, well, that would be a problem. I know a great deal more about you than you know about me.
How's that?
I am a very observant woman. Go ahead. Ask away.
Okay. Am I a morning person or a night person?
Morning.
Night. You wouldn't know that because you're always out like a light. You're snoring while I'm wandering around.
I don't snore. And you better not bring that up in front of the interviewer. It'll be our first marital fight.
My lips are sealed. How about, what's my favorite sandwich?
Ham and cheese.
Almost.
Swiss cheese.
Bologna on rye.
I've never even seen you eat it once.
Yeah, my dad showed me how to make it. He said it was essential when you're out on the road.
Sounds like good times.
Yeah, we had a lot of good times. No, I'm not even supposed to speak to him.
Until he goes to rehab?
If he goes to rehab. That's a big if. But you know what? Our marriage is the one bright spot in my life right now. It's Elizabeth. Second. Hello?
Dad?
Cam, what's up?
Can you come over? Mom's sick.
Yeah, of course. I'll be right over.
I didn't mean it that way. Falling in love with you was out of my comfort zone. There was a part of me that wanted to retreat, put my walls back up.
Wait, isn't that my thing? Aren't I the one that puts walls up?
Look at our self-awareness is growing by leaps and bounds.
In all honesty, you have been so great at therapy.
Well, I have a lot to make up for.
I know I let you down, too. I have this habit of wanting things my own way.
No.
It's okay, you can say it. Everybody knows that I'm controlling.
Well, I'm, what did you say? An egotistical jerk?
Egocentric.
Egocentric.
But, yeah, you can be that guy, but you can also be the guy that makes the best blueberry pancakes.
That is true. And I will hand that recipe down to Emma. Hopefully that's not the only good thing that I hand down to her.
I think we're doing the most important thing, which is showing her what a real family looks like. And the rest of it, well, we'll deal with it as it comes.
Elizabeth? Elizabeth!
Suzanne here. Can I talk to her?
Are you sure you want to do that?
No, not even a thank you. Thank you for finding my son. But, you know, you shouldn't have taken Carly, right? You should have taken me, but we'll talk about that later.
I'll go get Suzanne.
You know, instead of complaining, I think you could be a little grateful.
Look, I felt like I should be with my son.
Right, but Dante put his badge on the line to rescue your son. So, I don't know, instead of complaining that you weren't invited along, you could be grateful. I mean, he's here and he's alive and well. Would you rather be in Elizabeth's shoes right now?
You want to go in? I'll have an officer waiting outside.
Wow. have just lied to me about everything, haven't you?
Everything!
Even about my own child.
I did it for Alec. And if you're any kind of a mother, you'll follow in my example.
Suzanne, bringing that sweet little boy here, telling me that he's my son. That poor kid must be so confused. You know how devastated I was when I thought that he'd been kidnapped?
I was determined that Alec was going to have a safe, normal life.
Oh, really? No, what you were determined to do is you were determined to get revenge because of Alexander's death, which was completely unintentional. You were determined to make sure that I was miserable for the rest of my life, to make sure that I paid for the rest of my life over that boy's disappearance. Because I guess, you know, what I really need to accept is that you really do hate me that much.
No, Brenda. What I hate is the life that Alec is going to have in the next couple of years.
No, please. Alec is going to be with his mother for the next couple of years.
And his stepfather. Sonny Corinthos, a mob boss whose children have been shot, kidnapped, almost killed more times than anyone cares to count. And now, thanks to you, Alec is going to be raised in that environment. Unless you can save him.
Don't you worry. Nobody that I love ever has to be protected from my own husband.
You listen to me, Brenda. If you want Alec to have any kind of a future that doesn't involve danger and violence and death, then you'd better pack him up and get him as far away from Sonny Corinthos as you can.
So what were you and Brenda talking about?
I just called her out on her lack of appreciation. I mean, you rescued her son. She's whining about not going along on the road trip. I don't know. I think she could say thank you.
Mm-hmm. I love it when you get all fired up like that.
I'm being serious.
Well, so am I. I mean, we should probably put it to good use. I mean, really, what more could a guy ask for?
Absolutely nothing.
Yeah.
Don't forget that.
Okay.
I went running out the door like a crazy person.
Cam was outside.
I was doing laundry and getting the boys ready for bed, and I went upstairs and Cameron stayed down here looking for one of his toys, and the door was locked. I know the door was locked, but he knows how to open it. And when I came downstairs, the door was wide open, and it was like Jake all over again.
Was he out in the front?
No, he was on the side yard. Poor kid, he was so scared. You should have seen his face. I dragged him inside and I yelled at him. I sent him to his room, and then I went to mine and I just cried. I didn't know he could hear me, and I had no idea he called you.
I'm sorry. You had such a terrifying moment.
Can you talk to him? Can you just make sure he's okay and reassure him that his mother hasn't completely lost her mind?
Of course. Of course. But listen, don't be too hard on yourself. You're not failing anyone.
I just shouldn't fall apart like that,
no,
ever.
It happens. I mean, it happens to me, too, at unexpected moments. And it probably will for a long time to come. But all we can do is just keep going, right?
Yeah. Just gotta keep going.
Here, come on. Let's go talk to Cam together.
Okay. Lisa? Yeah, it was so quiet, I thought you'd left.
Oh, no, I was just heading out.
Where were you?
I ducked into the kitchen, I had a glass of water. Is Emma okay?
Yeah, she's asleep. Listen, I kind of feel weird about this. I mean, I probably shouldn't even let you in.
Okay, that's Patrick and Robin. Please just don't say anything. We'll both get in trouble. We have enough stress. Listen, just go.
What?
The world that we live in.
Hi.
Hi.
Hey.
You look worried.
Everything okay?